Well, look, it's important to remark upon and mention what progress has been made. People, as I've said, have been spared an outbreak of infectious disease here. There hasn't been large-scale civil unrest. But the need for medical care is still great here. People are dying right now, as Sean was just talking about, dying every day because they don't have the care they need. Amazingly, though, the supply of doctors and hospitals, public and private, is actually shrinking here. 360MD, Sanjay Gupta investigates.
Best estimate, the quake displaced 1.5 million people. Injured or crippled 300,000. In the United States, the care this man, Mildred, received would be considered ordinary.
When did you realize that you were injured?
Here, Mildred is an extraordinary success story.
The worst injuries that he had was actually to his leg. And I don't know if you could tell so far, but he's actually walking with a prosthetic here. This is what so many people here in Haiti have been wanting. They've been waiting for, because so many amputations were performed.
Mildred is a success here because he not only received immediate acute care, but because there are resources for his recovery and his follow-up. Intermediate care, it's so important. But here, it is way too rare.
Who's this gentleman?
It's a trauma.
It's about the money. There's never enough. Aid organizations tell us they are saving so much of it for the long term. But in the meantime, hospitals are dying, and so are patients.
This little girl has been left here to die. She had hydrocephalus, too much water on the brain, and the shunt to drain that fluid became infected. Now there's nothing more they can do for her.
You see, she got the acute care, but it's the same stupid story. 6 months later, she needed antibiotics that she couldn't get. She will die. The money. One U.S.-based charity, Medishare, has spent nearly all of $7 million it raised from private donors. But if they don't get a larger share of the public donations by September, that's it. This hospital shuts down.
Within a month and a half, you're saying the money runs out?
Yes.
We were sitting here talking, the three of us, just a few months ago about this very issue. And we said, you know, literally people were giving money, more than $1 billion they were giving all over the world. How does a place like this shut down? The only critical care hospital in the country, how does it shut down if so much money was given?
Where's the money?
We ask ourselves the same question.
Where is the money?
The medical needs will not miraculously go away anytime soon. But remember this?
They actually think there may be too many doctors.
Not long ago, compassion was overflowing here. For a short while, there were simply too many volunteers. They had come in from all over the world. But now?
This is General Hospital, one of the biggest trauma hospitals in Port-au-Prince. Just a few months ago, this place was very busy, and now you can see there's hardly anything happening here. The tables are still left, yes. There's hardly any resources, any equipment. There's no doctors, and as a result, no surgery taking place. And it's not just the public hospitals, but the private hospitals as well. There are many that say the healthcare in Haiti is as bad as it's ever been. Many hospitals simply shut down for business.
So where is the money?
A lot of hospitals are starting to run out of money. Some hospitals have had to shut down completely. General Hospital, which is the largest public hospital in the area, it's sort of become a bit of a ghost town. What do you say to that? I mean, how do you address some of those concerns?
Yeah, you know, as everyone knows, the generosity of the American public towards the Red Cross, the American Red Cross, has been enormous, okay? And we've raised a large amount of money. We're also, you know, aware that, you know, other resources are out there via the government and support the government has received, okay, to get into the hands of the General Hospital. And we're flexible, you know, on what support our funds, you know, can actually give.
Back with Mildred, he wants to show me that he can not only walk, but he can also run.
Careful.
Uh-oh. Shit. Is it, pick it up.
You're right. That's one of the difficulties you just saw here, simply navigating the road. He was obviously running, but it's just a very uneven surface.
The journey here is so difficult, but until September at least, Mildred will get his intermediate care. Once left for dead, he is back on his feet, dancing even.
So if September rolls around, and this place has shut down, what happens to those
We're
patients?
We're really sad about that.
We begin right before the earthquake. I'm talking about a lot of patients with critical care will die.
So wait, those two doctors, you're saying their facility may shut down by September if they don't get funded?
September 1st.
That's incredible. I mean, those guys do amazing, life-saving work.
And the thing about it is, and this is what's so staggering, they were obviously open before the earthquake.
Right.
Huge demand, obviously more patients, and not enough resources to keep up. So even some of the resources that were available beforehand may not be available.
And afterwards, that little girl is going to die because she did not get antibiotics, which probably, what, cost a few cents?
Started as a simple infection, could have been treated by a simple antibiotic. It grew into a more aggressive infection.
But how can there not have been antibiotics? I mean, this wasn't during the earthquake, right? I mean, this was in the weeks
this
after?
This was in a couple of months afterwards.
In months after,
and
they
I'll,
still
I'll
didn't
tell
have
you the
an
real
antibiotic.
Problem is that so many of the supplies are here, Anderson, in Haiti, in Port-au-Prince. But the distribution is completely clobbered. I mean, simply getting
so one group doesn't know what another group has.
Today, and I'll show you more of this tomorrow, but today I was in warehouses that had, they were completely full to the brim at the same time that children in orphanages haven't received food in 2 months. Same thing is happening in the hospital, same thing's happening in camps.
I talked to former President Clinton about this today. We're gonna play part of that interview, but he was saying that these aid groups are not working together and that they're not informing his group about what they're doing, where they're doing it, and what kind of supplies they have. And a lot of these aid groups, I think, you know, they all are fighting for funds, they all
That's
are
right.
fighting to raise money, and they don't want to share in it seems like, in a lot of cases.
They're absolutely not communicating, and so many of the supplies are here, but the definition of success is not to simply get it here to Port-au-Prince, it's to get it to the people who need it, and that's not happening.
I mean, to know that that little girl is going to die because of antibiotics, which were here, but just somewhere else other than where the people could find is
unconscionable.
Just, yeah, it really is, Sanjay. Amazing reporting. Just ahead tonight, Jenna's story. She's now in Colorado, and it hasn't been easy for mother or daughter, a little girl who was adopted from here. We'll show you an update. Also, an update on our breaking news. New hope tonight, if the vents can be shut and the new containment system holds, perhaps finally stopping that leak. We'll be right back.